Hello Hunter H2O and welcome to this second video where we demonstrate how you can maximize the value from your Endress.com account. So here you'll see your Endress.com homepage where you can access previous cards, favorites lists, quotes, orders, and projects tool that will soon be released. In this particular demonstration, we're going to look at the Applicator selection tool, which allows you to select and configure instruments via the application requirements. So to access this tool, we'll go to product tools at the top, then we'll scroll to the bottom and click go to Applicator. This will then open up the Applicator homepage. So there's a number of different ways that you can select and configure instruments, either via the industry type or via the measurement task. In this particular demonstration, we're going to go via the industry. So let's click on our industry, water and wastewater. Then we can either select potable water or wastewater and sludge treatment. Let's go to wastewater and sludge treatment. It will then open up a very basic overview of a wastewater treatment plant, all the way from the sewer system to the effluent line, as well as the sub-processes for mechanical sludge treatment and digester and biogas treatment. We're going to go ahead and have a look at the instruments you can select for biological treatment. So click here. Then it opens up a page with the various different types of biological treatment, from intermittent aeration to membrane bioreactors, sequence batch reactors too. Let's go ahead and look at the MBR. So here it will open up a page describing or showing all of your typical measurement points for an MBR. Now we may not use all of these measurement points, but we can at least use some. Let's go ahead and configure the airline flow meter. So it takes you to a page with the best fit instrument for that particular application. In this case, the ProLine T-Mass F300 thermal mass flow meter. You can go ahead and have a look at all of the technical data for this instrument, or you can just add it straight to your cart. So click on add to cart, then we'll go for the 4-inch line size and it goes straight into the cart. If we then go back to the MBR homepage, and let's say we want to also configure a dissolved oxygen instrument. So let's go to the DO value here. Then it will take you to the page of the Oxymax cost 61D. We can add that straight to the cart. Then we can also add all of the auxiliary items that make up that measurement point. In this case, it will be a transmitter, then an assembly, then an assembly holder, all added straight to your cart. Let's go ahead and configure one more instrument, in this case, an ammonium analyzer. So click on ammonium here. It will take you to the homepage of the CA80AM, which is a colorimetric analyzer. We can add that to our cart, as well as the sample preparation system, which makes up that measurement point. After this, we can go ahead and have a look at our cart and see the instruments which we have initially selected. Now, in order to download the 3D, 2D CAD files to have a look at some pricing, we're going to have to do a little bit more configuration to those particular measurement points. Let's go ahead and complete the configuration for the DO probe. So if we click configure, it will open up the different parameters that we can configure for this particular instrument. So let's go non-hazardous, 0 to 20, fixed cable with an M12 plug, 15 meters. Let's also add some air cleaning to that probe too. Click apply, you can access the CAD file if you like. After we click apply, the budget pricing for that particular instrument is going to appear in our cart. We can go ahead and complete that for all of our other instruments. And in under 15 minutes, we configured all of our instruments for that particular upgrade. It's as easy as that. Thanks for listening. And in the next session, we're going to talk to you about flow sizing too. Thank you. Bye.